Welcome to a special edition of The Inside Voice. Composers and clinicians John Jacobson, Christy Miller, Rollo Dilworth, and Roger Emerson discuss the joys and challenges of music education, focusing on teacher-student relationships, repertoire, the value of reading sessions, and more.
Sometimes we have content versus relationships. Have we been so driven, have educators tended to be so driven by our content goals? We have to prepare for the concert. We have to meet this particular, we have to give grades for this. We have to do assessments. We have to do all these, this laundry list of things that we miss the opportunities to cultivate quality relationships with our students. And you all touched on it at one point about relationships and how we're all connected.
In our case, we are teaching music, but even before that, we're teaching people, and music happens to be the vehicle by which we are doing that.
Yes.
When I work with my own students, we talk about process versus product versus people. And as they develop their own teaching philosophy and their own methodology and learn those of others, they have to sort of figure out in priority. They have to prioritize in some way, okay, what's more important in this given moment, in this particular lesson? Is it the people? Is it the process by which you are teaching the music? Or is it the product, i.e. contest, i.e. performance on stage so that we can get the rating one, or whatever the case may be? And it's always going to be sort of a battle between those three words, I think, for all of us as educators in what we do. But I think if we begin to see how important it is to put people at the core of what we do, as opposed to, you know, sort of
process,
the secondary
or
the process or the product, then, and it's not to say that process and product aren't important, but first and foremost, you are teaching people. And when we lose sight of that, that's when we actually are sort of the opposite of our, of who we are as artists, because our artistry is all about authenticity and about connecting the human spirit and connecting on a deeper level, a human level. And so to not pay attention to those things or to make those things a priority actually takes is the opposite of what we're trying to do as artist teachers or teacher artists,
well,
or however you want.
Would
to
you think that you know, sort of that what you're talking about, the for instance, the attention to detail that you use when you're teaching content like that is part of the process of creating a more disciplined human being? I mean, it is what you use
absolutely
to teach authenticity.
Absolutely.
Is quality is important.
Yeah, absolutely.
You know?
Yes.
Often I focus on those lyrics and I find out, is this going to be something that we can make a lesson from?
A life
and,
lesson.
A life lesson.
Yeah.
And, you know, I know it takes time to do that. You've got to set it up. You've got to ask them their opinion.
You've got to see, how does this relate? But if you take the time to do that, then you can do anything you want to with the product and the content. It will come across because they buy into it. They are like, I'm yours. I'm going to go ahead and do what you want because I love this song. I know what you've taught me about it and life and how it relates.
Start with the lyric and work out.
Yes.
You know, in answer to your question, I think actually there are more and more music education programs similar to what Rollo is advocating. As an ACDA board member in California, there was a real thrust to make real music, to really make the text paramount. And so I think if we backed up 5 years, 10 years, I'd say, yeah, we got a problem, but I think we're moving in the right direction. I've seen a concerted effort to truly make music.
But that's not to say that pop music isn't important, because through that process, you get to have fun and relate, and you know that also finds its place in your choir. But there's got to be those moments when they hit some sort of string inside each of those kids where they go, oh, and that's why we are in music, because somewhere along the line, we had that turned on.
And it always ends up being their favorite piece.
Well, I would talk to some colleagues who said, I don't have time. I can't take time to spend on talking with my students that much. And I said, I can't imagine not taking the time.
That's the answer.
Because sometimes, even though it might take up a little bit more time, the payoff down the road is so much greater.
Right. Well, and that's where you get, I mean, it sounds like you're describing someone who is much more product oriented. Mm-hmm. And, you know, while sort of going back to something you mentioned earlier, while it's important, I think, for us to have that common language with our peers, I mean, again, in my own teaching of my students, we talk about things like, you know, creativity, collaboration, and critical thinking. Yes, you can achieve that through a music program, you can achieve that through teaching social studies, through teaching mathematics, through teaching English, but I don't think we do enough to advocate as music educators for the things that we do uniquely beyond that common language. I mean, what we've been talking about today is developing the human spirit through the music, through the text, so that's very important. And also, we find ways, going to John's book, Place in the Choir, which is a very great book, by the way.
Way to go, plug that book.
I love my Place in the Choir. And what he alludes to, which is something that's more, that what he talks about in the book, but what a lot of scholars are talking about in music education now, is how we in choral programs provide a safe space for our students in ways that maybe not the same in an English class or a physical education class. And again, that's through discussion, that's through, you know, performing songs that talk about inclusiveness and diversity and accepting others and finding who you are and building community, as we talked about. So I think we have to do more to advocate for, you know, as music educators, to talk about that which we do that is separate from what perhaps is common with the other areas, and how necessary it is to develop the human spirit and to help people to feel safe and to develop their social emotional skills in ways that, frankly, sometimes a math class.
Why? You're not
going to
talk about compassion in a math class,
right,
or tolerance,
exactly,
necessarily.
Exactly.
Not to belittle what they do. It's important too.
Exactly, yeah.
But to be able to talk about hope and perseverance and gratitude and you know, all of those sorts of human characteristics and values that we truly value. Mm-hmm. And then our whole mantra, I think all four of us sitting here would agree that, you know, when you learn it through music, you don't forget it.
Mm-hmm.
When Roger and I do this show called our little show called The Musical Adventures of Lewis and Clark. The sixth grade teacher comes down to the classroom and says, "What are you doing down there?" She said, "What are you talking about?" "Well, we started our unit on explorers today, and I said, does anybody know anything about Lewis and Clark?" The whole sixth grade went, "It was 18-4, not a day before I left my home and family." Now, I'm not sure it's crucial knowledge, but they're going to remember forever that it was 18-4. Well, what if they also learn about the human spirit and compassion and gratitude and hope and tolerance through music? It might just stick.
Yeah. Well, you know, Tim Lotzenheiser gives that whole, his whole talk on the myelin memory of the nerve that basically absorbs that physiologically.
Yeah.
You know, this isn't just, it isn't just, just fun stuff to do. It actually, you know, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. It's right there. You learn it. It's
there. You know, there are still some people that are amazed I can name all the states in alphabetical order.
I can do it too, faster than you.
The 50 nifty United States.
Alabama.
Colorado.
Yes, I know.
I love Florida, Georgia, Hawaii.
How about how Bill got through Congress?
Oh, that's right.
Conjunction, junction. Where's your, what's your function? Right?
Yeah. Buckle up for safety.
Exactly.
Yeah. Well, I got a N-E-S-T-L-E-S. Nessie's makes the very best.
Chocolate.
Yeah, we don't know where our car keys are, but we know that from 1960 or something like that.
That's true.